us direction from above. We need a word from the Lord. A word from the Lord. Just one word from the Lord.
Abraham,
live.
Amen. We want to thank you for joining us again here at the Household of Faith. It's good to see Sister Claudia back in the house. Amen and amen. And we want to get a testimony from you a little later. We're going to go ahead and get into our lesson tonight. We're going to be talking about fasting for deduction. Deduction. Let me see what I have up here. I may want to read a little bit more on here. Go ahead. Click that button. Click it again. This is a good quote from Foster's book, again, about fasting. And this is in his book, and actually a quote from John Wesley. He says, "The fast day was a glorious day, such as London has scarce seen since the Restoration. Every church in the city easy, more than full, and a solemn seriousness sat on every face. Surely God has hears prayers, and there will be yet be a lengthening of our tranquility." Amen?
Amen.
And he was talking about a day of fasting. I think it was a threat of war that was going on during his time. And continue on until we get to our lesson tonight. But our fasting and praying, the bulk of it is why we're praying as a church, is we're praying for that same kind of revival. And though we're not in wartime or in threat of wars, we're dealing with some very serious issues in our culture, in our society, and in our communities. And it is a perfect time for people to get serious about God.
Yes. Yes.
For them to seek Him out. You know, there's threats of what's going on at the state school. You know, this is a marvelous time for them to seek God out and to learn to trust Him. And if you're in that institution, now, I would be fasting and praying. Amen?
Amen.
But we want to fast and pray so that people will be in this church as they did and have that solemn seriousness, as he said, about what God is doing. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. That's why we're fasting and praying. And tonight we're going to be looking again at a lesson of fasting for deduction. And we're going to be reading, and this is a bit long, Mark chapter 9. And I think we're all familiar with this story. It's four slides, but I'm going to read us this whole story so we can get context, because this is the basics. Tonight's lesson is the basics to why we're fasting and praying. Amen?
Amen.
So let's read this out loud at the same time on three. One, two, three.
"And when he came to the disciples, he saw a great multitude around him, and the scribes disputing with him. Immediately, when they saw him, all the people were greatly amazed, and running to him, greeting him. And he asked the scribes, 'What are you discussing with them?' Then one of the crowd answered and said, 'Teacher, I brought you my son, who has a mute spirit, and wherever it seizes him, it throws him down. He foams at the mouth, gashes his teeth, and becomes rigid. So I spoke to your disciples that they should cast it out, but they could not.' He answered him and said, 'O faithless generations, how long shall I be with you?
How long shall I bear with you? Bring him to me. Then they sought him to him. And when he saw him, immediately the spirit convulsed him, and he fell to the ground and wallowed,
foaming at the mouth.
So he asked his father, how long has this been happening to him? And he said, from his childhood. And often he has thrown him both into the fire and into the water to destroy him. But if you do anything, have compassion on us and help us. Jesus said to him, if you can believe, all things are possible to him who believes. Immediately the father of the child cried out and said to Jesus, Lord, I believe, help my unbelief. When Jesus saw that the people came running together, he rebuked the unclean spirit, saying to him, deaf and dumb spirit, I command you, come out of him and enter him no more. Then the spirit cried out, convulsed him greatly, and came out of him. And he became as one dead, so that it is said, he is dead.
But Jesus took him by the hand and lifted him up. And he arose, and when he had come to the house, his disciples asked him privately, why could we not cast it out? So he said to them, this kind comes out by nothing but prayer and fasting.
Amen. In the household of the Lord again today, we're sharing a lesson entitled Fasting for Deduction. And we're going to be looking at 3 points tonight. First point, we want to fast from childhood. The second point, we want to fast from challenge. The third point is we're fasting from, or really for, change.
For change.
Fasting for change. My thesis is tonight is that Christians should fast and pray for deliverance. Fast and pray for deliverance.
Amen.
Amen. Fasting and praying for deduction. A deduction is something that you want to take away. Many of you are doing your taxes and you get certain deductions. But in this text tonight, as we've read the text clearly, Jesus had been on that great mountain of transfiguration, and they had such a wonderful experience there. Well, they got to see the glory of God upon that mountain, at least the three who were closest to him and Jesus. But Jesus had to, and we have to, always come down off of our mountaintop experiences. And I pray that your fasting and praying has been a mountaintop experience.
Amen.
But now, since we have only a few days left, Sunday it'll be over, we're going to have to come off of the mountain, and we're going to have to learn to live in the valley. Well, when they came down off of the mountain, seeing the glory of God, the first problem that they face is where we are in the text. And Jesus, coming off of that mountain and going to the rest of the 12, where these men, having been with Jesus, should have been
another calm on the sea. But what we need is a special word.